Hey dudes, wow. Canon finally released the firmware update for the C70 that adds 4K RAW internal recording at 59.94p, as well as a couple of other new features. I'll play some test footage as we go. I only had about 15 minutes in my backyard between jobs, so don't be cruel. All right, let's get into it. Firstly, the link to the firmware update is in the description below. Canon, a little while ago, let the cat out of the bag that this update was coming, but now it's finally actually here. So what does this update add to the camera, and what does this all mean for C70 users? This long-awaited firmware update changes the C70 into a much more powerful cinema camera that can record 12-bit cinema raw light. Now, this is not news, but it is finally now a true beast. The cinema raw light files can be captured internally at up to 60 frames per second in 4K, and yes, you can still record proxies at the same time. All in all, Canon C70 users will now be able to record in cinema raw light ST at up to 30 frames and cinema raw light LT at up to 60 frames when shooting in Super 35 mode with no crop, as well as up to 60 frames per second using cinema raw light LT, ST and HQ in the Super 16 sensor mode, which is a very significant firmware update indeed. But the proxies, well, they're still limited to 4208-bit in the second card slot. There is also a new stop motion and time-lapse mode. I'll be testing the stop motion and time-lapse modes in the coming weeks, so if you're interested in seeing those tests and results, just hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and I'm pretty sure that YouTube will let you know when I post those videos. Now, also added was the much-awaited increased lens support for the 0.1x Canon speed booster, which brings it more in line with the Viltrox 0.71x speed booster for the C70. This update also adds the EOS standard and EOS neutral picture profiles. This now means that the Canon R5C, which is having major shipping delays and some recalls in another country, has a serious contender in the form of the Canon C70. If you don't currently own a Canon C70, an R5 or an R5C, which are all in a relative price bracket, this firmware update to the Canon C70 would have to make you seriously reconsider which camera you're considering, if comparing the C70 and the R5C as a purchase option. When you take away the high resolution of the R5 and the R5C, the Canon C70 just has so many more benefits, namely the internal ND filter, the DGO sensor, the high dynamic range, better audio preamps, longer battery life, better audio inputs, blah, 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 and the ability to be speed boosted. It is a true cinema camera, it's not a hybrid. The decision over which camera has better ergonomics would also be up for debate, but there is one place that will absolutely save you more money with the C70, and that is, it's just going to cost you less for media storage and for storage in post. And that for your clients is super attractive, because now you can offer more without spending more. This is a massive update for the Canon C70 and its user base, and it could just be the update that moved me away from renting the camera on the regular to owning it outright. That's it for me today, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.